Thank you. Breaks it back for the Drake Bulldogs. Melvin Mathis on the drive. Miller from the outside. Yes. David Miller.
10% of the time, they don't go man-to-man very often.
I like that 1-3-1 zone with Hawkins on the baseline. He's really quick, covers a lot of ground. Miller passes up the shot. Martin takes it from the outside. Much improved outside shooter. Here's Glenn Martin operating. He's got two from the field of 4 points this afternoon. Mathis giving the outside pop, and he'll hit it. Action. Drake in the early going, leading Bradley. We'll be back after these local messages.
And got a piece of it and tipped it in. That cuts the lead to 5.
Bradley in that zone. Beautiful feed to Mathis from Glenn Martin.
Now Bradley's going to
deserve national attention. Bulldogs on the inbound. The pass triggered over to the head of Melvin Mathis. Here comes Hersey Hawkins.
Oh. Showtime.
He can do it all.
Side wing, either Jerry or Greg. You look for the cross court pass. You need to go to pass to half. Unless they bring the guy to high post. If they bring the guy to high post, you're going to pass with him a little bit. Don't go all the way with him. He's got to cover the box. You'll be involved in the trap. The block guys are better than the wings. About 31 team. So you guys are the wings. Cover your box. You're keeping the ball out of low post. Trap the corner. Okay. They don't have a high post man, see if you pick it off. If not, don't worry about it. Then you go right back to 31. The only trap you can make is in the corner. Okay? The other end.
David Miller. Here's Morgan. Good move around Powell. Super move. Frederick inside. Powell the rejection, and Les comes away with it in spinning fashion. Jimmy Les does it himself.
Running lane.
Thomas missing on the free throw. Glenn Martin has it. 8 seconds to go. Time winding down. Martin trying to get the tying field goal. Martin with the jumper. Yes!
Continues.
Jimmy Les tossing on the inbound. 1 second remaining now for Bradley. Here's the baseball feed in, and they're trying to get the tip up by Hawkins.
Oh!
Yes! Does it count?
I think so.
Jimmy Les to Hersey Hawkins, and the Braves win it.
The officials,
in regulation.
The officials are gone, so it does count. You have to remember now, the clock does not start until the ball is touched. You got to keep that in mind. The clock does not until it's touched. So okay.
Watch this, the baseball feed from Jimmy Les.
Now watch when the clock starts.
Right there, see? Hawkins got it away before time expired, and that shot counts.
Absolutely.
Unbelievable. The Bradley Braves do, in fact, win it in regulation.
Inside, because Drake does have the players to shoot it from the perimeter.
There's one of them, David Miller. He's got 6 points. David Miller. Morgan, good feed to Mathis. Nice move around Riley. Morgan on the rebound bucket. Great effort by Michael Morgan. To the first 7 minutes of the game.
I think there's a real difference developing here between the offensive rebounding.
Glenn Martin from the outside finds the rain.
Those free throws are so important.
Frederick got the rebound. Somehow it lands in the hands of Dahlke with an incredible shot. Oh, my goodness. Day has a hand injury incurred in the game down at Wichita Thursday night. Watch Frederick.
Good low post move. Went up nice.
The rebound back tap to Martin. David Miller ahead of the field. 8 point lead with a minute 48. Mathis makes it a 2 point lead for Drake.
This is the point of decision. He makes this free throw, and they go up.
Thank you.
play very well, but I think Creighton played just had a great game plan and came in here and just beat us. I thought they played for 40 minutes and we didn't, and they stayed within their game plan and just beat us, and that's about the extent of it.
When was the last time you saw a couple guys like Swain and Evans shoot like that?
Well, they were extremely hot. You know, they just shot the lights out. And whenever a team that's as they're very well organized, they had a good game plan, and when they shoot that well, we have to play extremely well to beat a team that shoots well, and we didn't play well, and they played well.
Gary, what do you think hurt most, the offense or defense?
Well, I thought we were doing all right defensively. I just thought we didn't play as well as we're capable of playing offensively. They were just shooting the ball from extremely well. But the halftime, I thought we'd be okay. We look at their shot chart, and everything's coming from the outside. And we said, well, they can't keep that up, so we're in good shape. We got to get some offense going. But they did keep it up. And Swain's shooting 40% for the year, and at halftime, he's 5 for 8, and I don't know what he goes secondhand. But they just shot the ball well and played extremely well.
Any idea what was wrong on offense?
No, I think, you know, I don't think we've got any excuses. I think they just came in and beat us. I think, I was concerned about a mental letdown, but we've always come back from a loss, like the loss we had at Bradley, and come back and played well. So I don't think we can say, you know, I know some felt that, well, after we lost to Bradley, that we didn't have anything to play for until we get the postseason tournament. Maybe that's true, because we didn't play well offensively tonight and, just got beat.
How come Miller didn't start second?
David didn't feel good. He was back in the bathroom and just didn't feel good, and that was the only.
What did you try to do now to get him to bounce back?
Well, we got to have a good practice tomorrow. We got to have a really good practice tomorrow and get our spirits back up and see what happens down there Thursday night. Definitely hurt our chances. If we can win Thursday night and Saturday, that would definitely improve. But there's no question that this definitely hurts our chances.
Our book keeps playing man-to-man to start the ball game. There's Miller. Miller hits. Miller's a transfer from Wisconsin, and he loves in a row, but so far today, he's thinking about those big guys. That was almost a travel. But a basket there by Dave Boone, who's a transfer student, I understand. There you go.
I told Walter if he'd have come to Marquette while I was still coaching, I'd have been coach of the year. I'm mad at him.
There's a nice swing around hook by Frederick.
Want to get that weak side action.
Yep. There's Dimitri Sen. That's his spot.
It's just same thing at Marquette, just about. It's amazing.
That's his spot on the court. He's on. Steal by Miller. Miller's getting underneath. Nice defensive adjustment there. Miller had to make a move. Drake needed that little exchange.
Nice fake.
Beautiful.
Beautiful move. Beautiful move.
Number 44.
Beautiful move. Marquette's playing his own. On from the out of bounds, and they're staying in it. But you don't want to let Miller go.
Nope. They should have been out pushing him. Here, don't like it. Quick, we're going to have a problem here. The referee just went over the coach and told him to sit down.
You know, Gary, I think, has got a legitimate grief because there was no team, really. There was no one in possession there.
There was no one in possession. That's right. And that's Garner's complaint. Who had the ball? Who had the ball? Wow, that was a nice move. The last one, it could be 7 if you consider that Martin had control of the ball. There's... See a nice pass in there.
Beautiful.
That's what Morgan can do.
Beautiful.
Morgan can move and see the open man.
Now we'll see how smart Marquette is.
Beautiful play underneath. Boone is the basket. Dalkey with the foul. And there's, but more importantly for us right now, it's Drake University. The ball game ends 79-59. It is a victory for Marquette, a loss for Drake, but the Bulldogs end the year still on a good upward stride. I'm going to try to get Coach Gary Garner for an after-game comment. We'll be right back after these messages.
Yeah, we knew. I said many times that it was going to be a very physical basketball game and that the rebounding especially would be very physical. So, yeah, we expected that coming in. We know that... Marquette's an extremely strong rebounding team and a very physical team, and that proved to be so.
David Boone really seemed to be in control, especially early on.
Well, he's just truly a great basketball player. You know, I think he had 15 points at halftime. I don't know how many rebounds he wound up, but he's really an outstanding player. He's not one of those flashy type players, really. He just gets the job done. He's a great player.
How did a team like Marquette, especially inside, compare against some of the other Valley teams you played against this season?
Well, I'd say they're probably more physical than any team in the Valley. I wouldn't say they're better than any team in the Valley, but just as far as their physical front line, I'd say they're probably more physical than any team in the Valley.
Do you have that much trouble keeping track of the basketball? Do you get a lot of turnover?
Well, we have been doing extremely well in turnovers. I thought that was the difference in the basketball game. We had 14 turnovers at halftime. And if you look probably at our last 12 games, I'd say we probably averaged 10 or 11 turnovers. We've been extremely good at not turning the ball over. And then tonight, I don't have an answer for it, but we really turned the ball over, like I said, 14 times the first half. And you can't do that against anybody and be successful, especially a good team like Marquette, and then on the road also.
How many of those were caused?